This short little video is going to discuss vertical shifts and how they look graphically. So let's say we have a function f of x with inputs in the x column and outputs in the f of x column. If we wanted to graph f of x, we could think of this as a set of ordered pairs x, f of x. So we write them as ordered pairs and then we could plot them and we'd get the following graph. We can see our points plotted on there. Now, what we want to look at is how we can use this function to create another function. Let's say g of x, which is f of x, plus 1. Notice the plus 1 is outside of the parentheses. This is going to make it a change on the output. What that means is if we calculate the values for g of x, well, they're all the values for f of x plus 1. So we add 1 to all the f of x values. And now if we would like to graph these two together, again, we can plot the points x, g of x. And let's go ahead, here's our original graph, and plotting our new graph, what we get is the graph shifted up 1 unit. Because what we did is we added 1 to all the y values. Similarly, we could have moved it down 1 by doing f of x minus 1, which subtracts 1 from all the outputs. Writing these up as ordered pairs will allow us to plot it, and we see that our graph is shifted down. Thus, when we add or subtract outside the parentheses, we think of it as a vertical shift, because graphically what happens is our graph is shifted up if we're adding, down if we're subtracting some value. And we can generalize this, even though we did this just for the case where we added and subtracted 1, we could do it for if we added or subtracted any value.